गुड इवनिंग. लाइक आई प्रोमिस्ड यू लास्ट टाइम, आई एम बैक विद पार्ट टू ऑफ द वीडियो वेर आई टेल यू सम एक्सटेंडेड यूजेस ऑफ द वर्ड्स से एंड टेल. बिफोर वी जंप इन टू एक्शन, लेट अस क्विकली रिफ्रेश आवर मेमोरी. इफ यू हैव सीन द प्रीवियस वीडियो, यू विल नो दैट द वर्ड से इज यूज्ड इन अ सेंटेंस व्हेन द फोकस इज ऑन द वर्ड्स बीइंग अटर्ड. सिमिलरली, यू यूज द वर्ड tell in a sentence when the focus is on the information being communicated. I hope that was useful before we begin this video. And now that I've refreshed your memory, let me tell you some other uses to use the words say and tell in a sentence. When you use the word say in a sentence, it is not necessary to mention the receiver of the information in that very sentence. What I mean by that is that it is not necessary to describe who is hearing those words. For example, when I entered the coffee shop, the woman at the counter said, "Hello and good morning." Now in this sentence, I have used the word said. However, I have not mentioned clearly that she says this to me. Although it's an obvious choice, we just imply that she must have said it to me. However, I have not clearly stated that the woman at the counter said to me, "Hello and good morning." Similarly, when you're using the word tell in a sentence, it is always mandatory to mention the receiver of the information. For example, my friend told me this morning that she is going on a vacation to Goa. Goa sounds tempting at the moment, but this is the point that I'm trying to make. That here I have mentioned clearly, my friend was telling me, as in she mentioned to me that she is going to Goa for a vacation. Now the second rule to using the words say and tell in a sentence are as follows. You can use the word say to describe direct quotes. For example, Mahatma Gandhi said, double quotes open, "Be the change you wish to see in the world," double quotes close. Whenever a sentence is mentioned in double quotes, it means that it is as per the speaker, that is exactly how the speaker mentioned them. However, you never use the word tell to express direct quotes. So in the above example, you will not say Mahatma Gandhi told, "Be the change you wish to see in the world." Are you ready for a bonus? Good, because I've got one last rule for you as to the uses of the words say and tell. You can use say in a sentence to describe opinions. For example, they say you should drink 8 glasses of water a day. Now, this is an opinion. It's a general opinion which we've heard quite a lot of times, and here I am using the word say. On the other hand, you can use the word tell to describe less factual information, for example, jokes and stories. I would always say to my grandmother before sleeping at night, "Grandma, will you tell me a story?" I hope that rings a bell and that further clarifies your concepts of the uses of say and tell. Well, if you're with me and if you like this lesson, do give it a thumbs up and do like, share and subscribe to our Facebook, Instagram and YouTube pages. Keep following us for more such videos. Until then, happy learning. See you soon.